sense, a metaphorical sense again, but the fakir gets it. Therefore, al-Fatha, al-Hadith from Imam al-Bukhari, who others, al-Hakim and others, Abu Talha had a beard, had a hadiqa, basically a bustan or a little garden with a well of water in it. But he used to like it. So when the ayah was revealed, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرْ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. The ayah means, you shall not attain the maqam of birr, piety, closeness to Allah, until you spend from that you love most. Abu Talha radiallahu anhu, Abu Talha, Sahabi Azim, Jaleel, he came, he thought about this, he said, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I have this beer, and I love it so much, and since this ayah was revealed, I want to give this beer to you, Ya Rasulullah, فَضَعْهَا حَيْثُ تَشَاءُ. You put this beer, you put this hadiqa, or you put this farm, anywhere you want. It is up to this sadaqa fi sabilillah, lillahi wa rasulih. Look at this. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, قَبِلْنَاهَا وَدْنَاهَا عَلَيْهِ. I accept it, and I give it back to you, as long as you give it and share it amongst your people. It's not that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants something for himself. Share it amongst your people. بَخِنْ بَخِنْ في رواية البخاري. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is a good thing. This will never perish. Ya Abu Talha. Notice. That's why when النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم told سيد عائشة بن المنير رضي الله عنها when they were giving the sheep and part of the sheep صدقة and when the word was said, well, we gave everything. No, no, we actually kept everything. We gave everything for Allah, but that means we kept the reward of everything. We didn't really give everything. Notice. So therefore, you see now, يسألونك ما لا ينفقون قل العفو. When you want to give to Allah, give the best among the best that you have. Unless you think it's decreasing your wealth and no one is accounting what you do. For if you think there is a creator who knows what you're doing and why you gave what you gave, and you gave it sincerely for him, he will reward you not only double or triple, but multitudes that only he knows you have. Abadan. All the time, like this is a rule Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put. Al-afu. Because إِنَّ اللَّهَ طَيِّبٌ لَا يَقْبَلُ إِلَّا طَيِّبٌ. Allah is طيب, only accepts the things that are good. Allah accepts good things, not things that we want to do here and there. But لا, there's another meaning for العفو. يسألك ماذا يقول قل العفو. Some of the ulama, they said that العفو means what is excess. Excess of what you have. What does that mean? Yeah, I have this and this is enough for me. Not that I always, but I have what's basically enough for me. Then what I give, what should I give for the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I should give basically what is extra of my necessities. My basic necessities, what extra is, subject to giving for fi sabilillah. Jaa al-Baydawi, Imam al-Baydawi rahimahullah. Others mentioned that a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi with something like an egg worth or an egg shape of gold. That's all he had. Put it into gold. Prayed with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said, Rasulullah, خُذْهَا عَنِي صَدَقَةً. Take it from me, صَدَقَةً. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not take it from him. Didn't acknowledge him. Repeats the man. Ya Rasulullah, take it from me, صَدَقَةً. Three times. And he's insistent. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then the narration says he took it from him and then he gave it back to him. He said then, what is with people like you? That you give all what you have, ثُمَّ يَجْلِسُ لَتَكَفَّفُ النَّاسِ. Then you would start begging people for money. إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَةُ عَنْ ظَهْرِ الْغِنَى. A sadaqah is what is excess or it is extra of your basic needs. In other words, you cannot give sadaqah, all your money, and then you have nothing left. And then you want to go and beg people for money. A sadaqah that you give to Allah that is good and valid and accepted is the one that is after your basic needs. Then you give that. Huh? So al-afu here is excess. Now some people may object, rightfully so. They say, Shaykh, what are you talking about? How about the Siddiq radiallahu anhu, Abu Bakr? When Abu Bakr came and gave all his money, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not reject that. How come? We say because there is a Nabi al-Azam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks at people from the knowledge of Allah revealed to him. So he knows the darajat of yaqeen, the levels of yaqeen between people and other people. And he knows that the Prophet ﷺ, that when Abu Bakr came and gave him all his money, he knows that the yaqeen of Abu Bakr is different than the yaqeen of this man. Therefore, he accepted from Abu Bakr, but then returned to this man his money. Everybody is different here. Notice. So the yaqeen is also levels. Therefore, Umar radiallahu anhu, when he came, he gave half of his money. And Nabi ﷺ did not say no. Took it. But the other man, take it back. Not everyone is on the same level of yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and understanding. Therefore, you see from the seerah, and you see the seerah of Sahaba radiallahu anhu, you see Sayyidina Imam Hassan, for example, Hassan ibn Ali. And Imam Hassan used to, and most of the mu'adhikhi mentioned that he came out of his money two times or three times totally. Everything he owned, he just walked out of it like you walk out of your own house. And that's it, I don't have anything. Huh? And then, وَشَافَرَ اللَّهَ مَرَّتَيْنِ فِي أَمْوَالِهِ. And then he split his money with Allah twice in his lifetime. Three times he walked out of his money entirely, and twice he split his money with Allah. So much that the mu'arikheen, the historians used to say, that he would give, out of the pair of shoes he has, he would give one and he would keep one. Darajat, there are levels, again, we're talking about levels of the yaqeen and how people, those are, but also that someone does not, the point is, yani why did Prophet ﷺ tell this Sahabi that you should, I'm not going to accept it from you, so you know, fulfill your own needs, basic needs first. Because the point is that you do not supply someone else's need to make someone new needy. And there you go. You fill one area and you open up another. That's not the point. That kind of point is that you have your needs and then you do the other. That's number two. Number three is, look, ماذا ينفقون؟ قل العفو. العفو, what is العفو? They said, some of them said, this is the excess not in the individual pocket, but in Bayt Mal Muslimin. In Bayt Mal, the Department of Finance, the Treasury, whatever it has, excess. Now, nowadays there are no excesses, but in the old days, sometimes there used to be excesses. Whatever excess, then you spread it on people. Give it to people. Give it evenly to people. So much you all know how the Khulafa al-Rashidin radiallahu ta'ala anhum, you know how they used to deal with Bayt al-Mal. Huh? Not like the bonuses nowadays that people get. بينما يأتي there is narration of Sayyidina Ali ibn Mu'min comes to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who Sayyidina, that was in the time of Umar al-Khilafa. Umar is the Khalifa Ali, comes to him and says, Ya Amir al-Mu'miniyah. Sayyidina Ali says, Umar asks Sayyidina Ali, and one of them asks the other, he says, did you come to me for a personal visit or for some official visit? No. Ali says, I came to you personal visit. He says, okay, personal visit. There was a candle, he blew off, Umar radiallahu anhu blew off the candle. He says, the candle is from Bayt Mal al-Muslimin. This is a personal visit, so we should not spend the candle's worth of the money of the people on a personal visit. Huh? I'm not trying to compare with nowadays. I'm trying to compare with the good standards. In the time of the Khilafah of Sayyidina Ali, you see him after he gives everyone whatever they have. He cannot sleep if the money is still in Bayt al-Mal until he divides it on the people of Kufa where he was. So much that one narration says that he was left with one loaf of bread. So he divided the bread seven times based on the seven districts of Kufa at that time. You figure it out who wants to eat amongst you. But this is that. And then he would sweep Bayt al-Mal, him and Qanbar. Qanbar is his servant. Qanbar, you say Qanbar. Qanbar is university, I always say. Hada Qanbar, Allahu Akbar. Khatam al-Imam, he was the Khadim of Sayyidina Amir al-Mu'mineen.